Hi everybody, so I'm gonna vlog from the webcam because I don't have any more batteries on the flip, so sorry for the quality, but something's better than nothing, I suppose. I've gone a while without vlogging consistently, and it's not good. I've also gone a long while without writing, so it's doubly as bad. So today, I thought it was going to be a good day. I woke up and tried to think differently and positive. Last night was not a good night for me. I got into an argument with a good mate of mine, and we never argue, so it was a big fight, and so now we're not talking. And I don't know how long this is going to last. I don't like not talking to people, but I'm pretty stubborn, and he is equally stubborn, so it should be interesting. See who caves first, and it won't be me. So, it's Sunday, and I wake up, and I say, today I feel like fighting. Today I feel like fighting against the eating disorder and trying my best not to do behaviors. So that was the intention. For the most part, I did. I did pretty good. And then I did it. And then I ended up just bitching and purging, but only once, which is good. I've been going at it too much lately. So, I did it once, and then I fought against doing more behaviors again, so, yeah. I tried to eat as well. I decided that I wanted to eat something, keep something down, because I felt really bad afterwards. So I did it. I kept it down, but it just eating makes me feel bad, makes me feel guilty and weak, and I don't know. But I kept it down. So. So, the thing about having an eating disorder is that, you can't tell the good from the bad days. At least for me. It's hard to tell where the good day starts and when it turns sour. Or if it was just bad to begin with and I'm just fooling myself. Which is sometimes, what I think is the problem. I'm really uncomfortable right now vlogging from the webcam because I have to, unfortunately, have this camera hooked up to the television, so I have to look up here, but I also have to look here, and it just makes my neck hurt. So, yeah, it's hard for me to distinguish the good from the bad days, you know. So I've come to the conclusion that, maybe there are no good days. Maybe there are just bad days. And the times that I think that there's good in the day are just bursts of good. You know, it's just little samples of good. Little taste of happiness. And then it goes away. That's what I've come to believe. So, unfortunately today, it's a bad day. It's a bad day because I'm physically doing bad, very, very bad. And today is really bad for me. So, I've come back from the drugstore a little while ago. I had to walk in the rain. It started raining on me all of a sudden. Of course, it always rains when I don't have an umbrella. And, I had to go to the drugstore. I was not going to go, but I had to go. I had to go because today, unfortunately, I'm in a lot of physical pain. And I just didn't know what else to do and know what else to take. So I decided to go to the drugstore and just buy something. So I have horrible pains in my legs. My left leg is the worst. It starts from my knees and it goes all the way down to my ankles. It hurts really bad. It hurts to walk so much so that I am walking with a limp now. It hurts so bad that I think I need the cane again. And when I start walking with the cane, then it's not good. It's a bad sign. So I limped to the drugstore in the rain. And the drugstore isn't that far from my house. It's a couple blocks. But it hurt so bad to walk that I had to sit down at the bus stop for 5 complete minutes. I also had to sit down at the bus stop because I have had a headache for 3 days straight with no relief in sight. So it hurt so bad walking physically, and it hurt bad with this headache. I kept walking and it felt like every step I took was like a jackhammer barring down my head. Like I felt every step. It was just so painful. I had to stop. And I managed to make myself get up because it was raining too hard, and I knew if I stayed there it would just continue to rain and I would never get anything done. So I went to the drugstore and I just don't know what to get, you know? What do you get? I am constantly gobbling aspirin and ibuprofen, and I just don't know what to get anymore. So what I got was aspirin cream, and then I got some pills for arthritis because it feels like an arthritis flare-up. That's what it feels like. It feels really bad. My legs hurt really, really, really bad. And this is the worst pain I've had on you. So I I'm buying smelly aspirin cream and arthritis medication. I am like an old lady now. Just I need these things just to be able to walk, just to be on my feet. So I went back home and I gobbled up 4 pills, each 650 milligrams of arthritis pain medication, and I slather smelly aspirin cream all over my legs because now it's just not the left leg, now the right leg is equally as painful. But my left leg, for some reason, is bruising up where my ankles are. It's really bad. I have just bad bruises all of a sudden. I don't know what that could be. I haven't hurt my leg. I haven't got kicked in the leg. It looks like someone's just gone to town and kicked the shit out of my legs, but that's obviously not the case. So, I'm pretty worried about that. I don't know if this is like a preview of osteoporosis, which is what happens with eating disorders. Eventually your body just starts to really break down, and the wear and tear starts to come. So I don't know if this is a color preview of things to come, or if we're here already and I will never know how bad things really are because I don't see a doctor. So I have to kind of self-diagnose and self-medicate however I can. I have to be on my feet tomorrow. I have to work tomorrow for a few hours. I think it's like 8 hours I have to work tomorrow. In the pharmacy, you don't get to sit down. There are no more stools. You have to stand on your feet all day. Tomorrow I have to work 2 different stores, so, and I have to walk to 1 store, so. I don't know if I'm getting a ride or not tomorrow. There's, my ex has volunteered to give me a ride, but he's kind of a little emotional lately, so I don't think he's going to give me a ride tomorrow. I do have to go in the morning, but not so early. I have to go in at 9 a.m. So I have to leave the house and prepare for an hour's walk under the morning sun, if there's sun. If not, it could very well rain tomorrow and I have to walk in the rain, or limp in the rain rather now, with this new development, for an hour and then go to work and stand on my feet for 8 hours and then walk back home. At night, I get off at 6 p.m. and then walk back for another hour back home. So I'm not looking forward to that. My legs hurt so bad, I wish I didn't have to work tomorrow, but I have to go to work. I have to. I've had the opportunity, and I've been blessed this week to have 3 working days and plenty of hours. And I have to go to work. I don't have the luxury right now to not work, so. I actually got a call today from another pharmacy, and they were desperate for 2 technicians to work. But that pharmacy needs a car, so I had to turn her down. Unfortunately, I had to turn her away. And she was willing to work with my schedule, you know. She needed someone to stay till 10 p.m., so she was willing to just put me from 7 to 10. So essentially, if I had a car, I would have been working 3 stores in one day, kind of making more hours. If my car was working, I would have done it. But I have to work with what I have, and it's not much, so. My head hurts really, really bad. My legs hurt really bad. So, I have to work, unfortunately. I have bills that are due. I have a car that needs fixing. And now I have an upcoming back to school shopping list that I have to fulfill. There are new uniforms to buy, new things to get, new shoes, new backpacks, everything, and I have to do it. No one else can do it for me. I don't have the luxury of someone swooping in and saving the day for me. I have to do it. I have to save myself. I have to take care of this little family that I have. And the burden is all on me. If I didn't, if I had the luxury, you know, if I could not go to work tomorrow, then I wouldn't, because I physically feel bad. This is the worst I've felt in months. And that says a lot, because I feel bad all the time. All the time. Like I said, I don't know what a good day feels like anymore, because I hurt all the time. I hate my eating disorder so much today. So much. My eating disorder just takes away so much from me. It takes away my drive and my hope and my motivation, and it takes away my joy, and it takes away experiences and relationships. And I really hate my eating disorder for it. I really do. There are some days where I revel in it and I'm glad for it. And then there's every other day where I hate myself and I hate it. And I wish I were a tougher person, I wish I were a stronger person, where I could just not have this illness anymore. Where I could just not feel the need to have this thing in my life anymore, where I could just really be strong enough to let it go. But I don't know if I will ever be to that place in my life. I don't know if this thing will take my life. But I feel really bad. I have horrible anxiety today, really, really bad anxiety today. So, jeez. I wasn't planning on drinking, but I just feel so bad, you know. Need something to numb me. Hopefully this and pills will knock me out for a few hours. Give me a few hours of just numbness and quiet. No voices, no more aches, no more pains. No more inner conflict, inner turmoil. This is my nightly prayer. But, afterward, I finally was able to free up $50 to go towards the car. And that's motivation for me. Jeez. You know, today, you know what I feel like doing? I feel like getting a cigarette and just putting it out on my hand, on my neck, on my skin, just putting it out somewhere with it. It's so sensitive, you know? I really feel like doing that. I know that sounds crazy. Why do I feel like doing that? Because I know if I put the cigarette out in my chest or anywhere, it will hurt. It will hurt like hell. But it will also be a relief because I know that the pain from a burn is the pain from a burn. It's not related to my eating disorder. It's a different kind of pain. It's a new kind of pain. I sometimes welcome something other than my eating disorder. Sometimes I want to be sick in a different way, you know? And I know it's horrible to say, and God forgive me. I have things that could just get me. I have so much cancer-riddled family members and all kinds of cancers. I have a fucking rainbow of cancers that could get me. And I'm very much susceptible to. And sometimes I really wish that I would be suffering with something else other than this eating disorder, because then it would be like a vacation, you know, it would be like a break from this. But that's just how I feel sometimes. That's what, it's wrong to say anymore. I'm sorry for saying that. That's just how I feel sometimes. But I should count my blessings, you know? Things could be so much worse for me. It'll be 100 times worse. But today I feel bad, and I'm hoping that when I wake up in the morning, I will be okay to walk to work and be on my feet all day, and I'll be able to do my job well, so I can be able to still have a job and still be able to take care of my daughter and take care of what I need to. But yeah, I'm not happy today at all. I haven't spoken to anyone at all today. I think everyone's been leaving me alone lately. I've been talking less and less to people. Kind of isolating myself. Because I'm just trying to deal, you know? I don't want to be a burden. I don't want to be... I'm tired of talking about my eating disorder. I'm tired of talking about what hurts and how do I feel and what am I thinking. I'm tired sometimes. But it's good that people care. I'm glad that you guys care. I'm glad that I'm able to have fights with people that care about me. I think it would be the saddest thing ever if everyone I love would just get fed up and turn their back on me. I mean, I've had some people do that already, you know, the tough love route, which doesn't work with me. I'm sorry, it doesn't. But, I'm grateful for arguments, I'm grateful for fights with friends, because that means that you care. A friend, or someone that I can talk to, because they have someone close to them right now, with an eating disorder. So, in a way, I'm like their family, and, that's nice. It's nice to have family because I have actual family, but we are not close at all. And I can't talk to my family about things, so they don't understand. But it sucks when you fight with the ones that are your family because you need them. And you need them to continue to care because that makes you care, so. Like I said, I will not break first. And I was wrong, and I said a lot of things, and You said some shit too. I know your ass is watching. But, whatever. We'll see how this plays out. But anyway. So that's been today for me. I'm just in a lot of pain today, guys. I'm in a lot of pain. This pain scares me. I've been through worse. I could take a lot, you know? I've been through a lot. I can take a lot of hurt. I can take a lot of pain. I can take a lot of suffering. There are days like today where it just feels so, it feels so overwhelming. I just don't know what to do anymore. I just want to give up. So, with the utmost certainty, I can say today, fuck you. Fuck you, eating disorder. I really hate your guts right now. I hate that you take away so much from me, and I hate that you make me feel this way. I hate that I'm so young and I feel so old. I really feel like an old lady today. I need to walk with a cane, and I'm putting on smelly fucking cream on my skin, and I'm taking arthritic medications, and I hate it. So, yeah. I couldn't even enjoy Big Brother today, and I love Big Brother, and I just couldn't get into it today. And that says a lot. So, anyway, I'm gonna go. Just wanted to update you on what I'm doing. Let's see how tomorrow plays out. I don't know. I'm very anxious. I pray that I can make it tomorrow, and I know I will. I usually do. Like I said, it can take a lot. So, I'll let you guys know. Hopefully, I'll be able to write tomorrow. I haven't been very motivated to write. It's kind of hard, so. But I'm going to try to make myself. So, bear with me, please. So that's it. I'm going to go. This video, I don't know how long it is, and it's so annoying, and I have a headache just looking at the thing and looking up here and looking down there. And I feel like vertigo right now, which doesn't help the headache. So I'm gonna go. And goodbye. Good night.